Well, there it is. I'm in.
Bun?
I'm in.
What do you mean? What's happened?
Guess.
You got in the hand and racket darts team.
The hand and rackets dart team. That's it for you, isn't it? For you, that's the highest social and artistic achievement man can aspire to, isn't it? Nothing else, is there? I mean, to you, prime ministers, scientists, surgeons, writers, philosophers, are nothing next to a bloke who can get off with a double in his first handful, are they?
Well, you've got to admit it's hard.
I know it's hard. You don't have to tell me that. I've had the wall replastered 3 times since I've been playing. I felt quite pleased with myself when I got one to stay in the board. They all came round from the saloon bar to have a look. Cost me 23 and 6 in drinks, that did. Well, I don't lose my sense of proportion over it. There are other things in life than darts.
So you haven't got in the darts team?
I haven't got in the darts team.
Well, I give up. What happened?
I'm in. I've been accepted.
Accepted where?
Madame Tussauds.
Oh, blimey, you can go there any day of the week.
No, I mean as an exhibit. They're doing me.
Oh, is that all?
What do you mean, is that all? This is an honour, mate. Next to the garter and the bath, this is about as high as you can go. I've heard from the committee. They've asked for some photographs of me, and I've got to go up there for them to take all the measurements. What about that, then?
So you're going to be done in wax. So what's so marvellous about that? There's hundreds of them up there.
Look, don't try to belittle it. It's a great honour, and well, you know it. Means I've been recognised for what I am. Means they think I'm pretty important. Let's face it, they don't have any old yob in there. It's only the cream they bother about, as you know. I mean, I've never been one to blow my own trumpet. But it seems rather apparent to me that this is my acknowledgement of my fame.
I don't know. They made inquiry for me before now.
And I know what for. They had you down as the one in the sack. Burke and Eyre were dragging behind them. Don't you worry, boy. They want me upstairs among the gents.
I know. Somebody's asked for your autograph.
Pardon?
You've been recognised in the street and they've asked you to sign their book.
What's he talking about? I've told you what happened. Why don't you listen when people are talking?
I'm sorry.
All right, then. Anyway, I'm very pleased about it all. Always fancy myself behind the ropes, one hand out, one in the pocket and the grin. When the man gets here, I think I'll...
What's happened, then?
To what?
Well, what's happened? You came in here pleased about something and you wouldn't tell us and you said for us to guess what had happened and we tried and we were wrong. And you said you told us what happened and I ought to listen when people are talking.
Well?
Well, what happened, then?
Talk about grasshopper minds. Now, look, listen carefully.
Yeah?
Can you hear me all right? Are you with me? 1, 2, 3, 4, testing. Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday. Are you on? Have you got a level on it?
Yeah?
Right. Cop this. I am going to be exhibited at Madame Tussauds.
Ah, oh, that's ridiculous. You wouldn't be able to stand still long enough.
Not me personally. Isn't he a jackass? A dead jackass, you are. They made a wax model of him and it would be mentally superior. Sure it would. They're exhibiting a wax dummy of me. Now do you understand?
Oh, wax dummy. Of you.
That's it.
What a good idea.
Yes.
Yeah. Why?
Because I'm famous, that's why. Why do you think why? As soon as a personality becomes famous, they shove him in the waxworks.
Oh, is that all?
Don't you start. This is a great moment in my career. I'm being immortalized in wax for all time.
Don't you kid yourself.
What do you mean?
It's only temporary. They have a clear out every year.
Clear out? What clear out?
Well, you know how it is. Fame is a fleeting thing. You're all right now, certainly. But you do a couple of duff shows and psh, you'd be melted down, just like that. I reckon I make a couple of jockeys out of you.
They wouldn't do that, would they?
What? I've been there 3 times in the last 5 years, and each time, a complete change of program.
What about Crippin? He's still there.
Oh, well, he's still popular. He's a big draw, that boy. It's people like you, here today, gone tomorrow. Yeah, I reckon the wax will hardly have time to set before they melt you down again.
A right couple of knockers you two are, aren't you? Most exciting thing that's ever happened to me, and you have to put the mockers on it.
I'm just telling you, if you want to be immortalized for all time, you ought to go for the stone or the bronze. Lasts forever, that stuff. Why don't you get Henry Moore to knock up a head and shoulders for you?
No, thank you. I don't want great holes stuck all over me. Outside a block of flats with honorable kids crawling through them. Not a bad idea, though, the statue. I must say, I have toyed with the idea of being set up in the market square. I see myself in full armour, sitting on the horse. But then again, what would a comedian be doing in armour?
Oh, I don't know. You could have done with it at Glasgow.
That's true. That's very true. No, I think I'd better settle for the waxworks, seeing as they've asked me, you know, just for a start. I'll see how it goes, and perhaps I'll get something done in marble. Grecian, perhaps, with the toga and the empty eye sockets. With a big snake wrapped round me and me strangling the life out of it.
Yeah, marvellous. I definitely think the waxworks is a bit dodgy. They've only got to leave the radiator on all night, and there you are, flowing out under the door.
Yes. Still, first things first. They want me for the waxworks, I'd be silly to turn it down.
Well, it's up to you, mate, if that's what you want.
Well, let's face it, there's no harm in it. It can't do any damage to me.
Well, I don't know about that.
Ah, hello. Here comes the authority. What do you know about it?
Well, I think it's dangerous.
Oh, dear, here we go. I suppose we're in for another one of his morbid superstitions. Come on, cheerful, what is it this time?
Well, there's something sinister about wax models. Haven't you heard about black magic?
It's a song, isn't it, by Billy Daniels? That old black magic has me.
Oh, no, I wouldn't be worrying if it was just a song.
What do you mean?
Well, there's a lot of people who don't like you.
I'm well aware of that. I realise I'm not a knockout in all parts of the country. Half of my fan mail is abusive. You don't have to tell me that. What's that got to do with it?
Only that some people, when they don't like other people, make wax effigies of them and stick pins in them. And wherever that pin sticks, that's where it hurts you. No matter where you are, you feel it. And it'll drive you raving mad. Can even kill you. And that's only on little effigies. Thinks what they could do with a full-size one.
Yeah, Bill may be right, you know. I mean, you might be lying at home in bed one morning at 9 o'clock when the door's open, and then wallop, a dirty great hat pin goes right through your leg. It bears thinking about.
It does not bear thinking about. Load of old nonsense. The waxworks is full of unpopular gentlemen. They're not jumping about in bed covered in little holes.
You can sneer, but we Australians know better than to scoff at things we don't know about. Strange things happen in the bush.
That's nothing to the things that come out of it. Look at you. What a mess. Look at the shape of that head. Look at it. Look at his arms hanging down there. Positively marsupial at times.
Oh, they're not all like me. You take my Uncle Henry. He was like you. He scoffed at tales of witchcraft. Then one day he insulted an Aborigine chieftain. Uncle had drawn a moustache on one of his cave paintings. So they made a wax effigy of him and stuck pins in it each day for 3 weeks. And sure enough, at the end of it, poor old Uncle Henry had to go to hospital.
Why?
His mother was ill.
Yeah, well, what's that got to do with pins?
Nothing, but it just goes to show you, doesn't it?
It doesn't go to show anything. They stuck pins into your uncle and his mother went to hospital. I can't see the remotest connection between the two things.
Well, who knows? They might have transferred black magic to his mother as a warning. That might have been why she went to hospital.
Was it?
Well, no, she was expecting a baby.
I'm sorry, I'm lost. I'm right out in the woods here. I don't know what he's talking about. Now, let's concentrate for a minute. Let's go through this from the beginning. You with me, all right?
Yeah.
Come in, right. This uncle of yours...
Yeah?
He drew a moustache on the cave of the wall, and they stuck pins into a wax model of him, and he went to the hospital to visit his mother who was having a baby.
Yeah. Well, I'm telling you what can happen. You can draw your own conclusions from it. Stranger things happen at sea.
Look, don't bring the Navy into it. We're confused enough as it is. Look, if it'll help, if it's any consolation, I shall have my statue pushed back from the rope so no one can reach it, just in case.
Oh, they could stick pins on the end of a pole.
Well, if they hate me all that much, good luck to them.
Yeah, anyway, if they was to stick hat pins on a long pole, you could easily be moved behind someone else. Then you wouldn't be able to be seen.
But what's the point of being on show if nobody can see you? I want to be up there so that when they go past, they can say, oh, look, I recognize him. He's a card, isn't he? Oh, my word, very good of him. Very good of him, too. I like him. Oh, I do like him, yes. Oh, he's very good, yes. That's what I want, mate, the old praise. Recognition and plenty of it. Me or a lump of wax, it's all the same to me.
You're going to go through with it, then?
Yes, I am. I'm having my statue in the waxworks, and that is that. If you'd like to go up there with me, you're quite welcome, as long as you don't interfere.
Well, as your agent, I think I ought to go along to make sure it's done properly.
Look, Sid, what I think I ought to look like and what I think you think I ought to look like are two different things, so mind your own business.
Oh, good afternoon, Mr. Hancock. My name's Humphrey Williams. I'm the chief model maker.
And a very good one, too.
Oh, you've seen some of my models.
Just now, on the way through. Very good. I don't know how you do it. I really don't. I couldn't do it. Not to save my life, I couldn't do it. You must be very artistic. It must be in your hands. Show us your fingers. Ah, yes, Sid, here, look at his fingers. Look at them, look at them. Five of them there on each hand. See him throbbing away there? Can't wait to get wrapped round some clay.
Well, it is very kind of you, but then we all have our talents.
No, no, don't you be so modest. You're an artist, sir. You have my greatest admiration. You wouldn't like to do a couple of goblins in my garden, would you? A few toadstools, you know?
Well, I don't really undertake commissions of that nature.
I'll make it worth your while. There'll be half a bar in it for you. Half a quid and 25 bob for the bridge, how's that? I could put a lot of business your way. I have a lot of people come down, they'll see the goblins, they'll say, they're nice. Who did them? And I should say, Humphrey, up at two swords, he's a lad, he's good, he's... Yeah, you'd be in, straight in. You scratch my back, I'll scratch yours. That's the way I work.
Well, it's very kind of you, I'll bear it in mind.
That's my boy. Well then, let's get started. Oh, do you know each other? Sidney James, my agent?
I do.
How do you do?
And William Kerr, the red prong champion of New South Wales.
How do you do?
Yeah, charmed. Well now, Mr. Hancock, I've got the photographs you sent. They weren't very helpful. I can't really use the one on the bearskin rug or the one of you in the crowd at Wembley.
Well, what's wrong with that? You can see me. I put the arrow in, pointed to my head.
But the tam o'shanter does tend to hide the face. You see, we need much more detail of the features if we're going to make a lifelike model. Have you no other photographs?
No, I'm afraid not. You've got the lot.
Well, I thought a man in your position would have hundreds of photos of himself. I mean, have you no fan photos you send out?
At 10 bob a thousand? I should think so. I had 200 printed in 1945 and they're gone already.
Well, never mind. Never mind, perhaps we can do without the photograph. I'll make a few sketches. The measurements are the most important thing.
Well, of course, you're right there. I'm in an inch in the wrong place. Can make a man a laughing stock.
Quite, yes. I think we'll start with the head. Yes. Mm-hmm. I think about 14 pounds of wax for that.
I beg your pardon?
No, I assure you, it's quite usual.
Oh, for a moment, I thought you were insinuating that the cranium was a trifle grandiose.
Oh, dear me, no. No. Now, would you stand still while I run the tape measure over you? Thank you. Good heavens. 9 7/8.
What? What's 9 7/8? Where?
It's all right. I'm just measuring you for a hat.
Oh, I don't wear a hat.
Oh, dear. Oh, dear, I saw the model in an astrakhan coat and a Homburg, spats and patent leather shoes.
Oh, no. That is my Sunday walking out gear, I'll admit. But I thought for this a more casual approach, a more natural pose, like I really am when at home. Silk dressing gown, cigarette holder, Abyssinian slippers, Cossack pyjamas and a fez.
Mm. But that's not how the public see you.
Look, you may be a good model maker, Mush, but don't try and tell me how to dress, eh? I'm quite a fop, you know. I was the first one in East Cheam with the Italian look. And I didn't mess about. I had the earring and the scarf under me hat as well. I used to ask where my ice cream barrow was.
Mm. Was that how you want the model dressed, then, Italian style?
No, I've changed now. They're all in the Italian. One has to keep ahead of the layabouts, you realise. I haven't made my mind up yet. I'm alternating. I don't know whether to come right out in favour of the flare line or the matador.
The matador?
It's my own creation. The high-heeled boots, the thin pants, and the big hat with a bit of string holding it on. Very good for jumping on restaurant tables and doing the bolero.
Well, which is it to be, then? The flair or the matador?
Ah, yeah, that's what Savile Row are asking. As soon as they see which way I go, they'll be in. All the guards' officers will be on it. Straight out the barracks and billiardo in down the mall. Should be a grand sight. Could revolutionise the changing of the guard. Of course, the bands will have to brush up on their flamenco, but it should be very effective.
I see. Well, when you decide, let us know and we'll dress the model accordingly.
Ask him about the pin stickers.
Quiet. By the way, where will they be putting me?
Well, in the entertainment section, I suppose.
Well, I don't think that's right for a start. I thought I'd be in the great men of our time department. I'm not just a professional buffoon, you know.
Well, I'm sorry. It's the entertainment section or nothing.
Well, very well. I don't mind standing next to the titled members of our profession, in between, say, Lawrence Oliver and young Alec.
Alec?
Alec Guinness, the boy, you know. Oh. You might as well put me in with them now, because you'll only have to move me up there sooner or later. I've heard whispers, you know, it's pretty certain that... They reckon the sword before I'm 45 with a crafty garter next year to keep me going.
Tub, ask him about the pin stickers.
Stop pulling my coattails.
Well, now, if you would please stand still for a moment, I must get these measurements correct.
Wait a minute, just a minute. Before you go any further with them little sugar tongs...
They are calipers.
Yeah, well, whatever they are, I'm his agent.
Well, I'm awfully sorry, but we can't put you in as well.
Look, boy, look, just tell me this. How much are you paying?
I beg your pardon?
How much are you paying for the privilege of exhibiting my client?
I think you must be under a slight misapprehension. We don't pay fees, you see. It's considered quite an honour to be exhibited at our waxworks. The publicity is surely payment in itself.
Don't give me that, boy. I can't live on 10% of publicity. My client wants 20 nicker down, a fiver a week royalties for as long as he stands there, plus 2.5% of the gate money.
Sid, please.
Shut up. I do the chatting.
Well, this is preposterous. I mean, we've never paid anyone before. It's unheard of.
Well, that's our terms. You want him, you've got to pay for him.
Don't take any notice of him. I'll do it for nothing.
You will not. You're not doing anything for nothing while I'm around.
Well, I'm sorry. It's out of the question.
Very well. Come on, Hancock. We're not giving ourselves away.
Don't listen to him, sir. He's money mad. Get the measurements down. Chest 48, biceps 19, legs one of each. Waist 27... He's gone. You fool, Sid. What do you think you're doing? You know they don't pay fees.
I know that.
Now, what's the idea?
Use your loaf. We can make some easy loot out of this. I was watching the way he goes about it, this model making. It's dead easy.
Well?
We'll make one ourselves.
Oh, don't be silly.
Why not? How would you like to be the star exhibit?
What, you mean on my own?
Yeah.
With a rope round me?
Certainly. First one you see as you come through the door.
Sounds marvellous. Where?
Where else? The famous, world-famous Madam James Waxworks.
There is no such place.
There's gonna be, mate. There's a fortune to be made out of this lot. Did you see the crowds walking around when we come in? Now, look, we got the premises. The room's over the top of Addie's Billiard Saloon. All we gotta do is make a model out of you, then get hold of some throwouts from some tailor shop windows, dress them up, and put names under them.
The models are supposed to look something like the people they represent, you know.
That doesn't matter. The people we're going to exhibit, they've never heard of anyway. Then, after they've gone in, it won't matter. We'll have their money by then.
I refuse to lend my name to a shady deal like that.
You're going to be there. Star attraction up there, a rope round you.
No, I won't do it.
Velvet drapes behind you, a spotlight on your face.
I'm not listening.
Photo outside, your picture on the front of the catalogue. Any pose you like.
Would you make me a bit taller? I'm not saying yes, mind you.
I guarantee you 3 inches taller. We could also slim you down a bit.
Pick me your own costume?
Yeah.
I don't approve of it, you know. It's completely unethical.
What do ethics mean to an intellectual giant like you? Ethics are for we lesser mortals. You don't have to be governed by the same laws as the rest of us. You're above ordinary morality. You make your own laws.
True, true, true. He's right.
Man of your genius can't be hidebound by petty traditions and conventions.
On my own, with a rope round me?
Yes.
In the main hall?
Yes.
With a spotlight on me?
Yes.
All right, we'll do it.
Good boy. Bill, go out and buy 400 weight of candles. Now, I'll tell you what we'll do. We'll melt them down in the copper, fish the wicks out, and we're off. Well, we got enough wax here. Now what do we do?
I thought you said you knew all about it.
Well, I had to tell Hancock something. I know how you measure them. I know how you melt the wax down. Putting it together that bothers me.
I heard that. You know nothing about it, do you?
Don't worry. Don't worry. We'll find out. Can't be all that hard. Anybody got any ideas?
Yes, I have.
Now, this should be very interesting.
I saw a film called The House of Wax once.
Here we go.
And this madman...
Oh, Tom.
He made waxworks very lifelike. He dipped human bodies who he'd killed into boiling wax. Then he set them up and put them on show.
Don't bother to go on. I'm not being dipped in boiling wax under any circumstances.
Well, it'll be a perfect likeness.
Well, stone me, it ought to be.
Hey, wait a minute. He's got something here.
Yes, maybe he has, but he hasn't got me. Let's turn it in. It's not worth it. I can see what's going to happen. I'll go back to the other place. I'll apologize, and perhaps they'll reconsider.
You stay here. Come here. Look, how's this? We dip you in the wax, then we hang you up to dry, then we take you out, and now we got a perfect mold, right? So we pour into the mold some more wax, then in a couple of hours, we've got an exact likeness of you. Paint it, dress it up, and here we are. Go on, jump in.
Jump in? What do you mean you can't jump in boiling wax just like that? In any case, if you cover me in wax, how are you going to get me out?
Easy. We grease you up, make great big feet, and you can slide through the bottom.
Where does he get these ideas from? Let's dip him in wax and put him on show.
No, no, no. He's not a drawer.
I'd go and see him.
Oh, good. It's you we want. Now, let me see. What about the Iron Lady technique?
And what's that?
We put wax on you.
I see. We're still on the putting wax on me, then.
Oh, yes. It's the only way. But we put hinges all down the side, and then when it's set, we open it, and you step out.
Dead, of course.
We can leave a couple of holes for your nose.
Look, why can't we do it the old-fashioned way? You know, getting a bit of wax and shaping it and slapping it about with your hands and all that.
That's all right for experts, but we got to cheat a bit. Well, come on in. What's it going to be? A quick dive in or a slow pour over? Now, hurry up. We haven't got much time. We're opening tomorrow.
I don't care.
Why don't you think of us for a change? You're always thinking of yourself. Dead selfish, you are.
I am not having the wax over me, and that is that. You'll have to find another way. Now then.
Well, there it is. Not bad, eh? What do you think of yourself, Tub?
Disgusting. But this is nothing like me. What a monstrosity. Looks like a great fat Guy Fawkes up there. What's that head made out of?
A football?
Charming. You can still see the panels through the wax.
Well, those can be your wrinkles.
And how are you going to explain Billy Wright's signature on the side of me cheek? And what you made that hair out of, I do not know.
Well, it's your own fault. You wouldn't let us cut yours off. We couldn't get a wig off National Health, so we just had to make do with candle wicks.
Well, I think taking all things into consideration, it's not at all bad. Just the eyes to put in now.
I've got these here. A couple of marbles.
What a farce. Well, at least make sure they're the same colour.
They are. Two Red Riders.
I'm not having Red Riders stuck in my head. I want the natural shade. Ultramarine blue with two rather attractive golden flecks in them.
How do you reckon the body is? Not bad, eh?
It's horrible.
Good likeness, though, isn't it?
Well, the cleaner recognised you straight away.
I resent that.
Yeah, she said it was just like you.
Well, she's fired for a start. Another thing, what's all that string tied round the sleeves and the ankle?
That's to stop the wax flowing out. When it sets, we'll undo it. It's Bill's idea. We took one of your suits, starched it, stood it up, and poured the stuff in.
Well, I'm not stopping for the opening. I am not staying to see my name put under that revolting horror. I'm having nothing more to do with it. Good morning.
Hello, Hancock.
You see, I told you. I told you what would happen. A complete flop, wasn't it? Closed after the first day.
Well, we still made our money out of it.
How?
From the proceeds for your statue.
I beg your pardon?
Yeah, a bloke came in, took one look at it and offered to buy it. Said it was perfect, paid 60 quid for it.
He must be mad. What would he want a thing like that for?
To exhibit outside his cinema.
Oh. Well, perhaps it wasn't such a bad likeness after all. It's quite a compliment, really. Star of stage and television and forthcoming film star. Suppose he wanted to get in a bit of advance publicity.
Well, not quite. He wanted it to advertise the film he's showing this week. I married a monster from outer space.
This is an outrage.
It's a fantastic draw. There's a queue stretching right down the high street.
I don't care. I want it taken away.
Here's your share of the profits. 20 nicker.
Oh. Oh, well. I don't suppose it'll do any harm. People have short memories. They'll soon forget. I mean, I don't suppose anybody thinks it looks like me at all, really. I mean, I don't know...
Oh! What's the matter?
Pain in the leg. Like a red-hot needle going through it. Oh! Ah! Another one. Oh! Ah! Bite me nose.
They're at it. They've recognised you. They're sticking pins in you. You see, I told you.
Oh! Go and get it back. Oh, me leg. Oh! That was unfair. Oh. Go and give him his money back.
Not on your life. You try and stick it out till Wednesday. They change the programme then.
It's all right. Yoo-hoo! Ha-ha! It's up... My word! I say, what? What's that? What's it there? There's... By Joe, there's some dart players in the crowd. I know there are them. Ooh! Hello, double 19. Ooh! Quite well. What a disgusting thing.